Yeah, so this lecture is kind of checkpoint of what we have learned till now. So we started with Android basics of identifying an element using different techniques, and we have successfully achieved that with the help of XPath, IDs, class names, and we have also seen one specific lecture on handling using UI automator test, like executing Android code. Okay, so thereafter, once we are familiar with clicking, and then we have seen a method to how to send the keys in a basic method itself. Yeah, here itself we have seen how to send keys, how to type something into our Android apps, as well as how to click on with specific index. And thereafter we have went to gestures, and we have used touch action capability and checked how to tap on something and how to press and moving to specific operation and how to handle the pop-ups and how can you get the text from the specific app messages. And we have also seen how to swipe. Okay, we have taken excellent example of clock and we have swiped it from right side to left. Okay, and we have also seen scrolling with the help of Android UI automator, Android code. Okay, so how to scroll to specific element till it is in viewable mode, right? And thereafter we also seen some drag and drop concepts which explain how to drag and drop to specific location. And then we also seen some miscellaneous concepts on current activity, get context, orientations, and Android keyboard methods. Okay, so that's pretty much about a basic thing which you need to learn about Appium. We will do some one or two good end-to-end examples to get more confidence on this. And thereafter, we also see how to execute all this in a real device. Okay, so till now we are seeing how to handle this in emulator. So even in real device, everything is same, just a desired capabilities change, that's it. So here and there little changes are required to run this in mobile, real mobile device, and you need to have some configuration setup to make sure to run your device. We have some separate section dealing with that. Okay, and in the next section we will do some basic one end-to-end example using all these gestures to get, you know, enough confident on the Appium methods, right? So I think from this point you can slowly update your resume by providing by passing the Appium information that you worked on, because you are now familiar with a high level with the methods which are used in Appium and you know how to handle that. So rather than waiting till the course is entirely finished, if you are looking for job or if you want to switching a job into mobile automation, then you can start updating your resume with your Appium skill. And if you are not familiar, you can drop me a mail where I can help you in providing my resume inputs about the Appium. So how to put Appium experience in your resume. Okay, I can help you on giving some valuable inputs because Appium is very hot in the market. So people are looking like anything for mobile automation. So your resume makes a difference. Okay, so you can drop me a mail at Rahul Online Tutor at gmail.com if you want any resume assist. If you can prepare your own, you can please feel free to do that. And you can email me if you need my help. Okay, I will definitely help you by assisting with neat and valuable Appium inputs for your resume. Okay, so that's pretty much about this lecture. And in the next lecture, let's start with some end-to-end example working on Appium. Okay, thank you.